Okay, in this video, I'm going to show you how to compile a Java application using the command prompt. Okay, so the first thing we want to do is we want to go ahead and create a program. So I'm going to create a program inside Notepad++ just to show you in this example. So in Notepad++, I'm going to choose the language for Java. You can use any text editor you want. It doesn't really matter. You can use just plain Notepad. It's fine too. But if you want to use a Notepad++, you can go to you can search for it in Google and then just download. It's free. Okay. So the first thing I want to do is create a really simple program. Let me make this larger. You can see. So I'm gonna say it's gonna be a public class. Again, I'm going to use my, famous example, my first Java. That is the class name. Again, the class name will also be the actual file name of your project, your file. So we'll save that later. So this is my public class. And I'm going to have my main method. Okay, static void main. You have to have a main method in here. Inside the main method, it looks something like this. And the parameters are just basically a string array of arguments. You see a lot in the book, in a lot of other places as well, you have these args as the variable name. It doesn't have to be arguments. It could just be, Y or ABC. It doesn't really matter. Okay, but by convention, it's arguments. It takes one parameter, and then in here is where you would be outputting the data, a message to the console or the screen. So I'm going to say system.out.println print line. I notice that it doesn't have a really good IntelliSense like you would see in the Eclipse or the NetBeans IDEs. But so if you are already kind of know your way around Java, and you can use a plain text editor like a Notepad or Notepad++. Otherwise, I recommend using the other two so they can kind of help you out when you type your code. So I'm going to say again, hello. Hello world, if I can spell that correctly. Okay. And always terminate your statement with a semicolon. So there's no way of checking whether or not this code is correct, right? Because it doesn't have the IntelliSense to help me. But I think it looks good. So I'm going to go ahead and save this. And it will save it as a Java file. So I'm going to save inside the libraries inside the documents folder. Okay, I'm going to create a new folder called this is the Java 1 folder, and I'll put it inside the Java 1 folder. And the file name is going to, again, has to match my class name. Okay, so my first java.java. And in a Windows environment, and the naming doesn't have to be, the casing doesn't have to match. But if you're using a Linux machine or a Mac, then I think you have to match the casing as well. It's case sensitive. So make sure it has a .java file extension and click save. Okay. And then if you go to your file explorer and go into the documents folder, Java 1, and there's my file. Okay. So now we want to compile this code using the command prompt. Now to go to the command prompt, you just basically type here in your search bar, CMD. And then there's the command prompt here, and then hit enter or click it to load your command prompt. Okay, here at the command prompt, you want to do something like this, Java C, and then the name of that project is, which is my first Java, right? So you want to say my first Java. Again, casing is an issue here with Windows, but Linux, you want to make sure it's matches the casing. You want to do something like that. Okay, so if I hit enter, You notice that it says javac or javac is not recognized as an internal or external command. In order to do that, in order to make it work, we have to tell the operating system or the to find out where this file is. So it's looking for a file called javac. And so we need to set the path for the entire for the environment so that we can execute this command anywhere on the system here. So to do that, we need to go and find out where the JDK is located. Okay, so if you remember, if you install the JDK, it's inside your C drive, inside the program files, and there's a Java folder, and then the JDK. So make sure you select the JDK folder, and then in the bin folder, so it's gonna look for this file, Java. See, and then you will also need the Java to run the code. Okay, so we need to point the path to this directory here, and the easiest way is it's to basically just copy this file, this link here. Okay, if you don't copy it, then you have to type manually like this. You have to say set path, equals to, and then you have to say, oh, it's in C drive, and so on. That's too long. Okay, so we do a shortcut. So here again, if you're in the bin folder, just click in the nav bar here, and then just copy this whole link here. Do a control C to copy, or just right click and copy, and then come back to the console or the command prompt, and type in the command called set path equal sign, and then right after that, just do you right click with your mouse. Okay, if you right click it, it will grab it, and it will just paste it there for you. And then now you just hit enter. Okay, if you hit enter, and then if you don't see anything else, if you come to the next blank screen, like you see here, next line you see here, then it's all good. Okay, and just to verify, you can now type in JAVAC and hit enter. And you should be presented with a bunch of other options or other flags you can use. Right, so now we are good to go and run our code. Okay, so the next thing is we need to go and locate where we store our file, the Java file. It's inside the documents folder, right? Inside the Java 1, and this is the file. So if you want to change to that directory, you can do it from here. If you know a DOS command, or if you are Google Linux, there should be very similar. Or again, the easiest way is just go and then go here, grab the URL, copy it, and then go into your command prompt, type in CD, and then just do a paste here, and then hit enter, and it takes you right into that directory. And if you want to see what's inside that directory, type in dir. And you see that we have only one file called java dot my first java dot java. So we're in the same directory now. And so now we can go ahead and compile this file, compile it by using the command javac space, and then the file name, which is my first java. So my first. Okay, if you notice that I didn't type it, the whole thing, it just suddenly appears, right? So what you can do is that in both on DOS and in Linux, or Macintosh as well, I think, is that you can type the first few characters of the file, and if there are multiple files, it's going to grab the first one it finds. But if I type in the first couple characters in YF, and if you tab, okay, if you hit the tab key, then it should grab the whole thing and then just paste it for you. So save you a lot of typing. Okay, so I'm gonna compile it and hit enter. And if you don't see any errors, then that means you're good to go. If there's an error in the code or something like that, you'll see a bunch of errors, messages displaying your screen. All right, so that looks good. And now if I type in dir again to see what's in the directory, you'll see that there's a new file called myjava.class that's been added. Okay, this is the bytecode file. This is your source file. The .java, and then it compiled it into a Java, a bytecode file. Now, this bytecode file is going to be read or interpreted by the interpreter, And then this is the file that is needed so that the interpreter can talk to your machine, okay? So to run this file, you can now use the Java command without the C, okay? Just the Java, and then type in my first Java. Now, when you run this file, don't include the extension, okay? So just Java and then the name of that file, and then hit enter. Okay, so you see that hello world message is displayed right here. All right, if you don't see this, if you have any errors, please let me know. And again, if you want to change the text here, you will have to go through the whole process again. That means going back to your IDE, you can say hello Java world, okay, save your file, okay, go back here to the command prompt and recompile the program. And if you are not familiar with DOS or Linux, you can always press the up arrow key and it should bring you the any of the previous commands you typed before. So I want to recompile this file again. So javac, and then for java.java, enter. And then now you can run it by again using the up arrow key. Or if you don't see it because I didn't have it now, but anyways, you can type it my first Java without the extension. And you'll see that it has the text, hello Java world. Okay, so I hope this helps you to compile your code. And if you run into any issues or any problems, please don't hesitate to send me an email. Again, I'm not gonna, require you to compile your codes using the command prompt here. But it's good practice. So take some time and compile a few, programs so you know how it works. But ideally, when we get into the other chapters, then we'll be using mostly from within the IDE. Okay, thank you.